What's up, guys? It was recommended that I go through my pedal collection, and I said, why not? So we're just gonna dig right into it. I have about 14 pedals right now, so I'm gonna go through them and give you a brief description on my thoughts on each one. Let's nerd out. We're gonna start with my favorites, the EVH line. Number one, first generation Phase 90. So the first generation EVH pedals have stripes all the way around and a matte finish, while the new ones only have stripes on top and a gloss finish. Very cool pedal. Definitely recommend this one if you want a phaser and love EVH. It has a script button, so you can do script and non-script, and a speed knob. It's simple and incredible. Number two, gotta pair the phaser with the flanger. Again, generation one, it has the EVH button, which is the only button I use. You click it on and it has the unchained settings. I don't even think these knobs work, as I've never used them. I did put this on the pedal because I think I'm a funny guy. Great flanger. This is an 18 volt pedal, opposed to everything else is 9 volt, so supposedly that is why the flange is so freaking strong on this pedal. Number two, gotta have the chorus. They only do generation one of the chorus, so it only has stripes on the top, and as you can see, this one though is still a matte finish. This is a fantastic pedal for a specific, very stereo sounding 80s studio chorus. It's really a one-trick pony pedal, however, it is a very phenomenal sounding chorus. You have input and output controls, so it really gives you a lot of versatility in such a simplistic pedal. Lastly, in my EVH collection is the Wah. I think this is a fantastic pedal. I unfortunately covered up the EVH signature because I'm using this on my pedal board. However, it is in one of my favorite EVH patterns, being the Bumblebee pattern. This is a very, very strong sweep though. This Wah is not for everybody. I'm not gonna lie, I did not like it at first. I've grown to like it, but how strong the sweep is definitely takes some getting used to. That's it for the EVH pedals. I'm only missing the overdrive, which I really need to get one just to complete the collection. If anyone out there is selling one at a reasonable price, let me know. Shoot me an email or hit me up on Instagram. Next, time to get miniature, because I like mini pedals. This is the newest pedal in my collection. This is the Rowan Noise Gate. Basically, it's an NS2 or an ISP decimator for $34. I got this one open box from a company on Reverb for $27. It works phenomenal as a hard and a soft mode. It's a noise gate. What else can I say? There's not much to say about a noise gate. You all know this next pedal, my beloved pitch box. I really still only use this on the detune setting at -2 for the Van Hagar tones. Love this pedal. It is getting pretty beat up because I use it a ton. It is unfortunately not on my pedal board at the moment because I'm not doing any pitch bending in the current band that I'm in. However, I use this all the time at home. Great pedal. A lot of people have commented I'm the reason for the upcharge on these pedals. I do apologize, but you should still get one. Love this thing. Second newest pedal in my collection, the Golden Plexi from Tone City. I wanted this pedal for so long, don't know why I didn't just buy one sooner. They're like 50 bucks and it is a Plexi in a box. It's very weird. The gain control really only works from about 11 to 1 o'clock and then it just gets really fizzy. However, it is a phenomenal sounding pedal. Again, a one-trick pony, but if you want a Plexi style sounding amp through a clean channel, you gotta check this one out. I still have my Flashback Delay Mini because I love delay. Really, really love delay. I mainly use my SDE 2500 at home. That's my rack mount delay. However, I keep this one on my pedal board considering I don't really want to lug a rack mount around, and this is much simpler and sounds great. Paired with Hall of Fame Mini. I also really, really adore these pedal toppers. I'm gonna throw the link down below in the description of the ones I got. These are great, especially on mini pedals. Helps you not hit the knobs and just switch it on and off. Next up, the most complex pedal in my collection, TU2. Super basic, bought it really cheap because it is beat to shit, but this is the best pedal tuner on the market. Go buy one if you need a tuner. It's great. I could throw it at the wall. The wall's gonna break. This pedal is not. MXR Commandy Phaser, very fun little pedal. This one's a little quirky. I don't think it works right, but it's definitely fun to have. This was actually given to me by a subscriber. Again, thank you if you're watching. I love having this in my collection, and I just wanted you to know I still have it. The Commandy pedals are definitely a weird time in MXR history, but it is definitely fun to own one of these. Next up, another one of my favorites, the DoD FX60 Chorus pedal. Again, very simplistic. It's a CE2 copy, has the famous DoD switch that hasn't gone out yet, fingers crossed. And mine still has the battery cover, although it's fairly loose. takes the weird quirky 1/8 inch adapter, but that's all right. Things were weird in the 80s. That's why this pedal's weird. Definitely a fun pedal to have, and it sounds killer. GE7, cool little pedal. You know what this one does? It's an EQ. Great EQ pedal. If you want an EQ, there's really not any reason to buy anything else unless you want a 10 band or a 5 band, but frankly, 7 band seems to be just right for most people. And I saved my favorite pedal for last, and frankly, the most pricey pedal I've ever bought. Supernatural by Hardwire and Digitech, and it is basically new in the box, even has the stomp lock still packaged, all the original goodies and everything, and I just adore the look of this pedal. I think it is so cool and so classy. It still has the original Velcro strip in the box, however, I refuse to put Velcro on this pedal because I love it so much and they're so expensive and I want to keep it in this good condition. However, I probably will end up putting this on my pedal board at some point. It's gonna get beat up and I'm gonna get mad at myself, but that's just gonna have to be okay. Really cool pedal. I did a demo on this one just showing off the incredible sounds in here. Yeah, it's great. And that is all the pedals that I currently own. All right, guys, that is pretty much gonna do it for this video. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button, throw a thumbs up on this video, and any comments, drop them down below. See you guys later.